Good morning, students. Today we are resuming our chapter from page number 6. Peter Berg makes an unusual but effective comparison to make the profit. In an political or military conflict, it is the advantage to capture the information used by the intelligence organ of the opposing side. But this is so only because intelligence consists of information free of bias. If a spy does his or her reporting in terms of ideology and ambition of his or her superior, his or her reports are uselessly not only to enemy if the latter should capture them, but also the spy's own side. The sociologist is a spy in every much the way. His or her job is to report as accurately as he or she can about the certain terrain. And this is written by Peter Berg in 1963. Here, Peter Berg made an unusual comparison between a sociologist and a spy. He says that sociologist also works like a spy. He also collects information as the spy does. Does this mean that the sociologist has no social responsibility to ask about the goals of his or her study or to work to which the sociologist finding he will be applied? He or she has such a responsibility just like any other citizen of society. But this asking is not sociological asking. This is the like the biologist who biologically knowledge can be employed to heal or kill. This doesn't mean the biologist is free to responsible as to which he she serves. But this is not a biological question. Sociology has from its beginning understood itself as a science. Unlike common sensual observation or philosophical reflection or theological commentaries, sociology is bound by scientific canons of procedures. It means that the statement that sociologist arrives at must be arrived at through the observation of certain rules of evidence that allows others to check on, to report, to develop his or her finding further. And from the very beginning, we are learning that sociology is a science. So, sociologist, jo bhi statement lekar aa raha hai, it should be through keen observation. It should be under some rules and regulation. Kuch evidence hone chahiye aur ek proper report form mein hona chahiye taaki koi aur bhi use check kare aur apni findings and apni knowledge us cheez pe further use kar sake. There has been considerable debates within sociology about the differences between natural science and human science, between quantitative and qualitative research. We need not enter this here, but what is relevant here is that sociology in its observation and analysis has to be follow certain rules that can be checked upon by others. So, सोशियोलॉजी के ऊपर बहुत सारे डिबेट्स होती हैं कि क्या ये नेचुरल साइंस है या ह्यूमन साइंस है या ये इकोनॉमिक्स का क्वांटिटेटिव डेटा है या क्वालिटेटिव रिसर्च है. इस टाइम पे वी शुडंट गेट इनटू दीज टॉपिक्स. वी शुड कंसंट्रेट ओनली एंड ओनली ऑन आवर ऑब्जर्वेशंस. हमारी ऑब्जर्वेशंस इस तरह से रिकॉर्ड होनी चाहिए कि उनकी एनालिसिस कोई और भी कर सकता हो एंड रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस के थ्रू उसे रिकॉर्ड किया जाना चाहिए ताकि कोई और भी उसे चेक कर सके, अपनी नॉलेज यूज़ कर सके उस ऑब्जर्वेशन पे. इन द नेक्स्ट सिलेक्शन वी कंपेयर सोशियोलॉजिकल नॉलेज टू कॉमन सेंस नॉलेज विच विल वंस अगेन एम्फसाइज द रोल ऑफ मेथड्स, प्रोसीजर्स एंड रूल्स इन द मैनर इन विच सोशियोलॉजी कंडक्ट इट्स ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ सोसाइटी. Chapter 5 of this book will provide you with the sense of that sociologists do and how they go about studying society. An elaboration of difference between sociology and common sense will help toward a clearer idea of the sociological approach and method. Now on page number 7, fifth point, sociology and common sense of knowledge. We have seen how sociology knowledge is different from theological and philosophical observation. Likewise, sociology is different from common sense observation. The common sense explanation are generally based on what may be called as naturalistic and or individualistic explanation. A naturalistic explanation for behavior rests on the assumptions that one can really identify natural reasons for behavior. So now we learn what is कॉमन सेंस एक्सप्लेनेशन. सो कॉमन सेंस एक्सप्लेनेशन हर एक पर्सन की अलग होती है. ये एक नेचुरलिस्टिक प्रोसेस है एंड इंडिविजुअलिस्टिक एक्सप्लेनेशन इसमें होती है. हर एक पर्सन का अपना एक थॉट प्रोसेस होता है, अपना एक ऑब्जर्वेशन पॉइंट होता है एंड अपना एक अलग वे होता है उस चीज़ को समझाने का. On page number 8, there is an activity for you. An example of poverty has been given below, and we also touched upon it in our discussion on the homeless. Think of other issues and how they could be explained in naturalistic and sociological way. Sociology thus breaks away from both common sense observation and ideas as well as from philosophical thoughts. It does not always or even generally lead to spectacular results, but meaningful and unsuspected connection can be reached only by sifting through masses of connection. Great advances in sociological knowledge have been made generally, incrementally, and not rarely by dramatic breakouts. फिलोसफिकल थाट्स होते हैं कि हम किसी पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी में कैसे बिहेव करते हैं, हम अपनी प्रॉब्लम कैसे सॉल्व करते हैं. बट सोशोलॉजी हमें क्या सिखाता है? सोशोलॉजी हमें बताता है कि एक पर्टिकुलर इंसान किस तरह से सोसाइटी में बिहेव कर रहा है, उसकी ऑब्जर्वेशन बताएगा. सोशोलॉजी कभी भी हमें रेमेडीज़ नहीं देगा, कभी भी हमें सॉल्यूशंस नहीं देगा. वो हमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ ऑब्जर्वेशंस के बारे में बताएगा कि एक पर्टिकुलर सोसाइटी में एक पर्टिकुलर पर्सन ने इस तरह से किया. Sociology has a body of concepts, methods and data, and no matter how loosely coordinated. So this says that sociology observation ke bahut sare methods hote hain, jaise ki empirical method, scientific methods. Jaise ki hum census calculate karte hain, wo census calculate karne ka bhi ek method hota hai. To hum sociology ko ek substitute method mein nahi rakh sakte hain, chahe jitna ye loosely kiya gaya ho. But then as well hum is pe apne common sense nahi laga sakte hain. That means agar hum kisi particular aapki class ke bare mein ye baat karte hain, to hum proper sabhi students ka examination result dekh kar batayenge ki kiski kitni percentage aayi hai. Hum unki body language ya kis tarah se koi particular student class mein behave kar raha hai, wo dekh kar nahi bata sakte ki us particular student ka result kis tarah ka aayega. This cannot be substituted by common sense. Common sense is unreflective since it does not question its own origin. Or in other words, it does not ask itself, why do I hold this view? So common sense ki ek bahut badi problem hoti hai ki ye apne aap ko galat nahi prove hone deti. For example, let's talk about Brahmins. तो ब्राह्मण्स के लिए एक थॉट प्रोसेस बना हुआ है दैट ब्राह्मण्स आर द वन हु आर वेयरिंग दैट सीक्रेट थ्रेड एंड दे आर नॉट ईटिंग नॉनवेज. क्यों? क्योंकि कॉमन सेंस लोगों ने डेवलप कर दी है कि एक ब्राह्मण कभी भी नॉनवेज नहीं खा सकता. नॉनवेज गलत नहीं है, बट हमारे कॉमन सेंस ये कह रही है कि वो पर्सन गलत है जो नॉनवेज खा रहा है. ये क्या हो गया हमारा एक हमारा कॉन्ट्रोडिक्टरी थॉट हो गया कि जो मैंने कह दिया या जो मेरी कॉमन सेंस ने कह दिया वही सही है, सामने वाला सही है या गलत है मुझे उससे मतलब नहीं है. ये क्या नहीं करता? अपने आप से क्वेश्चन नहीं करता, व्हाई डू आई होल्ड दिस व्यू, ये चीज़ अपने आप से नहीं पूछता है. द सोशियोलॉजिस्ट मस्ट बी रेडी टू आस्क ऑफ एनी ऑफ आर बिलीव्स अबाउट आर सेल्फ नो मैटर हाउ चार्ज्ड. तो सोशियोलॉजिस्ट को हमेशा अपने से क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहिए कि उसके क्या बिलीव्स हैं, क्यों कोई चीज़ पर आपको रिस्ट्रिक्शन लगाई गई है. इज दिस रियली सो? बोथ दी सिस्टमैटिक एंड क्वेश्चनिंग अप्रोच ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम ब्रॉडर ट्रेडिशन ऑफ साइंटिफिक इन्वेस्टिगेशन. नाउ हियर इज वेरी वेल कोटेड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ पॉवर्टी. पीपल आर पुअर बिकॉज दे आर अफ्रेड ऑफ वर्क, कम फॉर प्रॉब्लमैटिक फैमिली. Here is very good example quoted on poverty. Naturalistic way says that people are poor because they are afraid to work, come from problematic families, unable to budget properly, suffer from low intelligence and shiftlessness. But sociological view says that contemporary poverty is caused by the structure of inequality in class society and is experienced by those who suffer from chronic irregularity of work and low wages. Student, this is very important thing mentioned on page number 8, that is explanation of poverty. You should learn it properly. So there are two things. One is naturalistic, second is sociological. So naturalistic thing means ki hum kya sochte hain, what we think about poverty. So jo log gareeb hai, hum ye sochte hain ki wo shayad kaam karne se darte hain, ya unka family background hi is tarah ka tha ki jo aaj wo bhi gareeb hain, ya inse budget nahi properly banaya gaya, ya inki thinking power bahut zero hai, ya ye migrate hokar aaye kisi ek place pe isi wajah se ye gareeb hain. But sociological view kya sochta hai? लोग गरीब क्यों हैं? क्योंकि सोसाइटी में इनइक्वालिटीज़ बहुत ज़्यादा हैं, सोसाइटी में काम अच्छे से बांटा नहीं गया है या लोगों को अच्छे से सैलरी नहीं दी गई है, इसलिए लोग गरीब हैं.